Philadelphia Auto Show.
Philadelphia Auto Show.
Philadelphia Auto Show.
2022 Philadelphia Auto Show.
The car. Arguably humanity's greatest invention since the wheel. An incredible machine born within the mysterious and complex organ that is the human brain. A miracle mechanism of science and engineering built to get from one location to the other. Something that has slowly but surely become a crucial aspect of people's lives since its creation in the late 19th century. And with people recognizing the potential in this new invention, more and more model cars were being built across America. With all these new cars being created, an idea was formed. An idea to get all the cars together in one convention, an auto show to be precise.
Have I been to?
Yeah.
I've been to a lot. I think probably like 10, probably 12.
How do you think this one will turn out?
I think this is going to turn out pretty good.
So. All right, you said it. All right. What else do you have to say about it?
I don't really know. I got to ride in a Jeep. That was fun.
There's a lot of cars.
All right.
That's really good.
That was awesome.
That's good.
So today, me and my buddy Sean went to the Philadelphia Auto Show to experience all the cars there firsthand. Now, to those of you who haven't heard about it, you might be asking, what is the Philadelphia Auto Show? Well, the Philadelphia Auto Show is an annual event hosted in Philadelphia's Convention Center, in which cars of all varieties are shown and presented to visitors. And these cars usually range from Teslas, Buicks, Centuries, Fords, Lamborghinis, Ferraris, not to mention old Cadillacs, Belfords, and station wagons. Since its establishment in 1904, the Auto Dealers Association of Greater Philadelphia, or the ADAGP, has owned and produced the Auto Show, and it is the oldest association of its kind in the nation. The organization is comprised of 190 franchised new car and truck dealers throughout the 5-county Philadelphia area. Philadelphia Auto Show is also sponsored by a foundation called Auto Dealers Caring for Kids Foundation, which acts as a philanthropic arm of the ADAGP. It is a 501c3 or nonprofit public charity, and the foundation's primary aim is to enhance and enrich the lives of children and the communities where its dealer members live. Since its incorporation in 2003, the foundation has contributed more than $12.9 million to area of children, charities, and organizations. The Philadelphia Auto Show also hosts a Black Tie Tailgate Preview Gala, which is usually held the Friday prior to the start of the auto show. Tickets that are purchased and proceeded from the Black Tie Gala benefit the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia, or CHOP, all through the Auto Dealers Caring for Kids Foundation, which contributes funding and resources for child-related programs and causes throughout the Philadelphia region.
Interactive experiences at the auto show is the absolute must now. Auto shows have changed over the years where now consumers want to be a part of the action. Now they actually want to see what it's like to ride or drive those vehicles.
CarFX loves coming to Custom Alley every year and displaying our vehicles,
It really allows us to be out with the public and talk about what we do. And it really allows us to get down at the nitty gritty and talk to the people and find out what it is that they're looking for to do to their vehicles.
But to those of you who are watching this and asking how this all started, don't worry, I'm gonna tell you. Beginning in 1902, the Philadelphia Auto Show had been around for over 100 years, in a time which cars started to rise in popularity as a form of motor transportation for Americans. But it should be noted at this time that cars weren't mass marketed and were only reserved for the extremely wealthy to purchase and drive. And it wasn't until a year later when Henry Ford started his company that cars started to go mass production across the United States of America. And because of that rise in popularity, more and more people across Philadelphia started to attend the auto show. And by the time of the Roaring Twenties, cars started to boom in popularity to the point where almost everyone had a car and everyone was talking about a car. And with new model cars being produced by companies like Ford, Chrysler, and General Motors, this only added to the level of cars that could be shown at the auto show each year for new visitors. But things weren't all well and good in the 1920s, as the Great Depression did hit in 1929. And while this did affect the automobile industry, with cars dropping over 75% from 1929 to 1932, it still didn't stop the Philadelphia Auto Show from opening up annually and accepting visitors in tough times. And this continued beyond the 1920s auto show. For example, 1939, 1949, 1962, 1988, 1990, and finally 2001. But that was then. Now the Philadelphia show is arguably more popular than it ever was when it started. The auto show has grown dramatically over the past several years, welcoming more than 250,000 visitors each year. As of the most recent one in 2023, the auto show has obtained over 700 cars from a laundry list of places, all in which come from a variety of foreign as well as domestic productions across the world. And these cars at the show can range from being exotic to conceptual to being art in a way. Another exciting addition to this year's auto show is the Ram Truck Territory, which will be appearing for the first time in Philadelphia. It is a 30,000 square foot track that will feature all organic materials simulating an off-road experiences. Professional drivers will drive guests around a course that includes multiple obstacles such as dirt moguls and rolling hills, also navigating over staggered logs and a 15-foot hill climb. One of the other events highlight that was introduced was the fully expanded E-Track, a reimagined and fully operational electric vehicle test track that was the center stage of this year's auto show. The E-Track this year was sponsored by Pico that offered guests an interactive experience that include ride-along opportunities in the latest electrical vehicles that include Chevrolet, Ford, Nissan, Toyota, and Volkswagen that are available. And it did it a lot of favors since it was one of the most popular events at the auto show. The auto show this year also welcomed back its Hollywood Rise displays, featuring some of the most iconic vehicles from today's biggest television shows and movies. Featured vehicles in this year's Hollywood Rise display will include such vehicle props from Fast and the Furious, the station wagon from National Lampoon's Vacation, Rick Grimes' police car from The Walking Dead, and even the Mystery Machine from Scooby-Doo, and even some really fun games. shows were all the primary events and highlights that I got to see and experience when I went to the auto show. Not only that, but I got to see cars that I never thought I would see in my entire life. And the most interesting thing for me was not only seeing the cars, but being able to film it and share it with other people. I mean, just spending the whole day being able to film all this was pretty amazing in my opinion, and educational. Not to mention all the research I did to figure out the event and uncovering some pretty interesting history behind the Philadelphia Auto Show. An event that, honestly, I wasn't completely interested in when I first heard about it when I was a little kid. But once I decided to get out of my comfort zone and try something new, this was a perfect place to go. And as what I gathered, many people feel the same way as I felt about the 2023 Auto Show this year. And that's pretty much everything I've seen and experienced there firsthand when I was there. And this being my first time ever, it certainly did not disappoint me. From the vehicles, origins, and history of the place that I researched while filming and documenting this, it certainly was an amazing place to visit over and over and over again, annually for the next few years for me. And I would strongly encourage others to do the same.